Imagine I have a button that generates a random number between 0 and 1, up to 4 decimal places, meaning the numbers can range between 0.0001 and 1.0000. Then I come to you with a game. It goes like this. You get to press the button up to 5 times, and whatever number you generate, you win an amount of money equal to 1 over that number. For example, if you got the number 0.0133, you would win 1 divided by 0.0133, which is about $75. The catch is, if you roll a number that gives you $1,000 or more, you lose all your money up to that point and get $0. The first press costs $6 and goes up by $1 on each press afterwards. How many times would you press the button? If you want to, pause the video and try to come up with an answer on your own. And if you find one, post it in the comments below. But stay tuned so we can explore the math behind it. Naturally, it makes sense to want to press the button all 5 times, because you're able to win more than the cost of each round, right? Well, when I first tried to solve this, that was my initial thought too. But then I found something called expected values that proved my theory wrong. Unfortunately, mathematicians do what they do best and turn a clear idea into something that looks like this. Now, if you're saying this all looks Greek to me, well, that's because it is, with some Latin thrown in there too. Let's break it down. Going from left to right, this formula says that for any random event x, the average or expected value of that variable is equal to the sum of each value x can be times the probability of that value happening. That was a lot of info, and if you need to, I recommend pausing for a few seconds to process it and ensure everything makes sense. Applying this to our game, we know the random event is equal to the number generated and the value of that event is the dollar amount won. But you may be asking, what are the probabilities? Well, we can find them using the rules of the game. Since our numbers can only have 4 decimal places, we know that the smallest number we can generate, let's call this S, is 0.0001. We also know that there are no numbers between 0.0001 and 0.0002 because there would have to be 5 decimal places for that to happen. This means all the different dollar amounts we can get, let's call this D, equals the amount of times we can add 0.0001 together before we get to 1, which is the same thing as dividing 1 by S. This equals 10,000. Now that we know how many different outcomes there are, we can find probabilities by figuring out how many of those 10,000 outcomes result in a specific dollar amount. On almost all the numbers, this probability is equal to 1 over D. To illustrate, imagine you got a number 0.0125. This is the only number that will give you $80 because 0.0124 gives you slightly more and 0.0126 gives you slightly less. The exception, though, are the numbers that result in $1,000 or more, because they all cause you to lose the game and take home zero. We can call these numbers L. To find L, we first divide 1 by $1,000 and get 0.001. This serves as a threshold on the numbers we can generate and means any number between 0.0001 and 0.001 will lose us the game. We do a trick similar to before and find that there are 10 numbers that will give us $0. Then we can finally take all these numbers to our formula. Plugging in our variables, we see that the expected value is equal to L over D times 0 plus all the other dollar amounts times 1 over D. Before we move on though, I'm going to make some slight changes to the formula to make it easier to deal with later. But all you need to know is that these two expressions mean the same thing. We can then turn 1 over D into S because of how the two variables are related and cancel out the S on the bottom, giving us the sum of all fractions ranging from 1 divided by L plus 1 to 1 divided by D. If you've taken some calculus, this expression might look familiar because it's a section of something called the harmonic series. I'll go into the details of it in a later video, but what's cool about it is that mathematicians have approximated what different parts of it evaluate to. Their estimate for any section of the harmonic series is the natural log of the last number in your range minus the natural log of the first number in your range. There's also something called Euler's constant, but it cancels out in the subtraction. Plugging in our values, we get the natural log of 10,000 minus the natural log of 11, which equals about $6.81. And that's it, we found the expected value. But that's only for the first button press. We still have 4 more we can choose to do. Luckily, we can repeat the process we just did with only one slight difference. Instead of the expected value equaling this expression, it now equals this one where we add the previous button's value onto the current one. This doesn't change too much. Mostly, it just alters the final calculation from this expression to this one. I'll save you some time and calculate the values for each step of the way. Now that we have all five expected values, we can finally compare them to what it would cost to play up to that point. And we see that if you press the button more than two times, you're actually expected to lose money. So, if you want to make money playing this game, it's in your best interest that you only press the button twice. And that's the math behind it.